G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. This week I've got four different photographs that we are going to blend together to make the Moon Fantasy Composite. But as usual, let's get started. I'm going to start off on our background photo here, and I'm going to get rid of the blue sky here. I'm just going to use my rectangular marquee tool and just make a square over the blue sky down here, just below the grass, and hit delete on my keyboard and command D to get rid of these marching ants. I'm going to use my mesh warp tool and just going to pull the middle up so it's just curved and hit apply up here. So we've got our grass now in position. Just going to use my blur tool and just go over quickly just on the edge of that grass. So we're ready to bring over the next picture now, and it's going to be the picture of this tree here. And to make the selection of this tree, I'm going to come down here to my channels tab and click on my composite green channel. I'm going to use my flood selection tool, the tolerance of 30%. I'm just going to click down the bottom on the tree here, and it's going to give me a selection of that tree. So the next thing I'm going to do is come down here to this little icon here and bring it back to color, and then click on refine. So Affinity is going to refine my selection, and we're going to get some that it's missed these little red leaves around here. So I'm going to make my brush really big. Just going to brush over the tree and let Affinity have another go at that and see what sort of selection we get. And that's given me quite a good selection of that tree. What I'm going to do now is just come down here to output and click on new layer and click apply. So now I've got a selection of the tree. I'm just going to use my erase tool brush because I don't need all that. So I'm just going to make that quite big and just get rid of this that I don't really need. I'm going to keep a section of the tree and the grass here, just about that much, and I'm going to blend that in when we move it over to the photo. And any other little bits that you want to take care of, there's a little bit of a brown leaf here, I might use my clone brush tool, quite a small brush, and just make a selection holding my option of part of the green tree here and just go over that brown and just make it look a little bit greener. I think we've got a really good selection of our tree here, so we can just copy that now with the command C and over to the picture of our grass and command V to paste that in. You can see we've got a few little bits left over here, so we can just take our erase tool and just get rid of those bits here. I'm going to click on my move tool, and I'm going to make my tree quite big. I want it sort of quite big all the way up to the top of the picture. So I want my tree right in the middle, so I'm just going to manipulate the tree and just keep rotating it until it looks good, tiny little bit bigger, and let's just blend it into that curve there. So a tiny bit bigger again, and move it down. So what I'm going to do now is add a mask to my tree. So I'm going to come down here to my mask icon and click on that and add a mask. I'm going to come over here to my brushes and again pick that nice soft brush and click on my brush tool. I'm going to bring that flow all the way down to about 3% because I want a really, really low flow. And with my brush painting in black, just going to blend that tree into the background of that grass. And I want to sort of keep some of those roots that are going there a little bit. So that looks pretty good. I'm happy with the way that tree is looking. So now we can add our next photo in, and we're going to add our model in. So we're going to come over here to our model, and I'm going to use my selection brush tool for this one and just make that a little bit bigger with my command plus. And my brush a little bit bigger, my left and right bracket keys. And I'm just going to make a selection of the model. If you don't want to watch this selection, you can fast forward to the next section while I do the selection if you like. Once you've got your selection, we can come up here again to refine, and then just let's zoom in a little bit and use our refine brush just to go over some of these areas on the hair. And command zero just to return to normal size, and let's go new layer for that one as well and hit apply. And now that we've got our model on its own layer, I like to use this little blur tool here just to go around the edges, just to soften those edges up a little bit. And the other thing that I like to do is just grab my erase tool and zoom in a little bit. And if there's anywhere that needs a little bit of a cleanup, we can just clean that up around the shoes or anywhere else that just needs a little bit of cleanup. Not too bad on this one, so just go around and have a look, and I'm quite happy with that. Command zero to get back to the normal size, and then we can bring our model over to the other photo with a command C, into our main photo with a command V, up to our move tool, and we can now place our model running up the hill towards the tree here, and I'll place her about there. Looks pretty good. So now we've got our model in place, we can come over to our next photo that we're going to add, and that's going to be our background. I'm going to use this moon here. I'm just going to copy this picture as it is and take it over to our main picture and command V straight into our main picture, and I'm going to bring this picture all the way down to the bottom, all the way down, so it puts it behind the grass. And now I'm going to use my command minus to make this really small and make this picture really big. So let's just resize this picture. It's the moon that I want, and I want the moon to be on the other side, so I'm going to come up here to arrange and flip horizontal, and I want to get my moon back right near that tree out there. Looks good. Command zero to make it bigger, and we can just move our moon wherever we like, and I think that looks pretty good at the moment. Make that a little bit smaller with a command minus so we can see what's going on. And I do want to bring the birds back into the picture that were on this photo here, so I'm going to use my rectangular marquee tool and just make a small selection around those birds, and command C, back over to our picture and command V, change the blend mode to darken, and we can make them a bit bigger and turn them around, just place them up here a little bit bigger like that. And because that one's sort of that, we can't see it too well, I might just grab my erase tool and just erase that one out. And that looks pretty good with our birds back in the picture. So now we can start actually adding all the other elements on this picture now, like our shadows and our highlights. So let's click on our model layer, click on our move tool, and I'm just going to move my model a little bit straighter. On my model, I'm going to add a new pixel layer on top of my model. I'm going to grab my color picker and pick a really dark color in my picture here, one of those dark purple colors. Grab my brush tool. I know I still have my nice soft brush, and then I'm going to grab my purple color. Clicking on my model, I'm up here to select and selection from layer. Make sure I'm on my new pixel layer here, and again, let's make sure our flow is 100%, and let's color in that model to get her to blend in a little bit better to this picture. Let's change the blend mode to soft light. Let's grab another pixel layer and let's pick a nice light color in the picture, sort of the light color of the moon here. Activate that color, make sure we're on our new pixel layer, and color our model in. And let's change the blend mode on that to multiply and bring the opacity down to 50%. And now get rid of the marching ants, and we've got our model blending in a little bit better. I'm going to use the darker color of the model for my shadow. So I'm going to go Command J, bring that down underneath my model, come down here to Layer Effects, do a color overlay. Turn that black. Let's click on that shadow layer, come over here to our move tool, and let's move that down. So we've got that shadow coming down. Let's move the shadow all the way around to the side here because this is where our light is here. Let's turn our opacity all the way down to 22%. 22% on our opacity, making sure we're on that shadow layer. We can move that a little bit, turn it around and stretch it a tiny little bit. That's our shadow for our model. Okay, we're going to do the same for our tree now. Let's make a copy of the tree with Command J. On our copy, we don't need the mask layer, so let's delete the mask. Come down here to Layer Effects, add a color overlay to our tree. Making sure we're on our Move tool, let's pull that layer down as well. Move our tree into place, the shadow for our tree. Stretching that quite a bit and moving it quite a bit to the side. Let's change the opacity down to 22% as well. And let's get that into a better spot here. About there, looks pretty good. And just for all this overhang of the shadow, I'm just going to use my erase tool and just erase that we don't need, that shadow that we don't need. Let's get rid of it all. Okay, so we've got our shadows in place. You want to turn that opacity down a little bit more, maybe to 20% is good, and also for the model as well. Let's change that one to 20, a little bit lighter. So we've got our shadows in place. The one on the model, I might just turn around a little bit more, maybe on that side there. Okay, so we've got our shadows in place for our model and our tree. Now let's add some highlights. So we've got our light coming here onto the moon here, but we've got sort of no light on the tree here. So let's add to the tree a brightness and contrast layer, and let's just clip that tree. Let's turn our brightness all the way up. And on that brightness and contrast layer, let's invert it with the Command I. Let's change our colors back to default by clicking D on our keyboard. Let's come over here to our brush tool. Now we want to be painting in white for this. So let's click X on our keyboard to get our white as our foreground color. Let's drop our opacity again really, really low to about 3 or 4%. Make our brush fairly big. Let's brush some of those highlights onto the tree here. We've got that light coming from the moon onto the tree, just on that front side. Let's make the picture a little bit bigger, and let's make our brush a little bit smaller. And let's do the same on the trunk of the tree here and paint the highlights from the moon, from wherever that light source is coming onto the trunk of the tree. Okay, Command 0 to make that a little bit smaller. Let's copy that brightness and contrast layer with a Command J. Let's drag one up to our model here as well and clip it to our model. We can do the same now to our model. We've still got our brush, nice soft brush, and we've still got our flow at 4%. We can just paint some of those light onto our model as well. Doesn't really need a lot because the white dress, but let's just add a little bit. It's very subtle. You can't really see too much of it, but just a few of those highlights. Command 0 to get our picture back to normal. Okay, let's add a few more things to our picture here. Let's just go Command minus, make it a little bit smaller. Right on top, let's add a curves layer all the way on top. And again, I'm just going to darken the picture a little bit, flatten the blacks a little bit to make that little S curve again. And there we go. I'm quite happy with that. So I want to go a little bit further with this picture, just stretch it a little bit further. So I'm going to click on the top layer here, hold my shift key down and click on the bottom layer. I'm going to come up here to layer and I'm going to click on merge visible. That's going to put all these layers into one picture. I'm going to come over here now to my tone mapping. I really like the way tone mapping makes the picture look, and I'm going to pick the detailed one once my tone mapping has come up. It's a bit slow. I'm going to click on this detail one. It's going to add a lot more detail to my picture. I'm going to bring that down here to about 70%. And I'm also going to bring the exposure down a little bit. And the other thing I'm going to do is going to bring the saturation all the way down and then just bring it up and just till I see those colors coming through. And I think about 60% looks pretty good. Now, you don't have to do this step if you don't want to. This is just an extra little step just to give that picture a little bit more detail and make it a little bit more sort of looking like a fantasy photo. So I'm going to click on apply. And then the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this curves again, Command J, and just add that on top just to give it that little bit of a darker look. So there you go, everybody. That is my tutorial this week on the fantasy moon photo. If you have enjoyed the tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit that notification bell and smash that like button. And if you'd like to support my channel, head over to the Buy Me a Coffee site that I've created. The link will be below. And while you're over on the Buy Me a Coffee site, I'll have these two pictures here of the tree and the model already cut out as PNG files. You can download those two absolutely free. Okay, until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.